Wow, I bet Warner Brothers, Dwayne Johnson, and Noah Centineo's agent are real surprised that Centineo joined the DCEU yesterday and nobody cared. In fact, some of you are even a little upset. But I think that this is the disconnect between fandom and Hollywood, because Noah Centineo is a big deal in Hollywood. I cast him as Hercules, remember, in my fan casting? And a lot of you thought that was ridiculous. But as I told you, he's, you know, on Hollywood's radar. And so I'm sure they were like, we got him. And then nobody cared. Or like, throw him back. Because, you know, there's not a lot of overlap between fans of All the Boys I've Loved Before and DC Comics. But, you know, again, this is about expanding the audience for Black Adam. So Noah Centineo, well, I think also what's problematic, though, is that it didn't excite his fan base either. They weren't like, oh, what's this? Maybe when we see a picture of him or something, they'll show up. But no one from either camp, Noah Centineo or DC fans, you know, either fandom cared. And that's alarming. Now, so far in covering Black Adam, I have to say, I see a general lack of interest across the board from even the most casual, even casual DC fans, like people who like DC, but, you know, only glance at it now and then. They aren't hardcore like most of us, right? It's difficult to get people to pay attention to this movie, unless Dwayne Johnson's involved, or if they have a cool visual. Visuals always help. But people just aren't too interested in Black Adam or the JSA in general, I think because they don't know very much about them. So, and I think that might have been a problem with Shazam as well, by the way. Maybe Dwayne Johnson should have gotten more well-known properties for his company to produce. But these are the ones that he has. I mean, I loved Shazam, and that had trouble, you know, garnering interest as well. And don't worry, Dwayne Johnson, I'll help you guys educate the fan base about these characters. And I think it's interesting, but, you know, as long as Noah Centineo eventually gets his fans to the box office, Warner Brothers will be happy. And hopefully, he won't upset too many of you. Is he going to really keep any of you from watching the movie? I mean, there are a lot of cool characters to be cast, as we're going to go over here. We'll go over again. I've already reported it to you, but I'll reiterate it. So, you know, I think there's stuff coming down the pipeline for Black Adam that's going to get your butt into this theater anyway, and then, you know, we'll see who's sitting next to you. It might be a fan of To All the Boys I've Loved Before. And on that note, there's no way they're going to cover his face in this movie. He even takes his face mask off sometime in the comics, particularly when he had his romantic storyline, which we'll also touch on. But yeah, there's no way that they're going to cover his face, because anyone who is buying a ticket to see Noah Centineo is paying to see his face. It's not like he's a great actor and, you know, you'll be able to, you just want to have his essence. Fans of Noah Centineo want to look at Noah Centineo. So, I mean, you explained to fans of To All the Boys I've Loved Before about the importance of comic book accuracy. And really, how many fans does Adam Smasher have anyway who are going to be like, where's his damn mask? Well, Smith didn't cover his face, and we all ended up being fine with it as well. As I predicted, this is going to be DC's Fast and Furious. It's definitely shaping up that way, and Noah Centineo is totally that kind of casting. I'll be concerned if the rest of the casting goes in that direction. If I don't want it to be too Fast and Furious-y, but then again, that's what Dwayne Johnson knows. And I have to say, in his defense, from a business perspective, what has worked for him. So why deviate from what works for you? And the crew this time around, as I previously reported, is going to be the JSA. And now we have our very first member who's been cast, Noah Centineo, as Adam Smasher. But wait a minute, isn't he supposed to be He-Man of Masters of the Universe for Sony and Mattel? He was. And he signed that deal over a year ago, but Sony recently just took it off their release schedule. And he even had already bulked up, so he's capable of bulking up. Maybe his agent sent those pictures over to Dwayne Johnson for the role of Adam Smasher. He said, like 30 pounds of muscle. So that sounds like it's going to do it. And so he should be able to bulk up again for this movie. So they decided at the last minute to delay He-Man, because he was ready to go until right before the pandemic, when the movie got delayed, perhaps indefinitely. Now, He-Man, interestingly, was set for spring of 2021, and Black Adam is set for the holiday season 2021. So I think Noah Centineo and his team recovered very nicely from the loss of Masters of the Universe, by adding Black Adam. Now, of course, he was going to be the star of Masters of the Universe, so I guess it is a bit of a downgrade. But still, he's as I've told you, Jack Nicholson so famously told Terry Garr, an actor acts. Noah Centineo's got to work. I don't know. You might debate whether or not Noah Centineo is acting, but he's working, and this continues his career. Now, how do I feel about him as Adam Smasher? Well, again, Adam Smasher's not that well known. So this gives the film, directed by Joan Collette Serra, reteaming with The Rock after Jungle Cruise, which, by the way, while I loved both of its trailers, had a hard time getting people to talk. I don't know why The Rock's properties are having difficulty trending. Is it overexposure? Is it they're all very much the same? I mean, Jungle Cruise doesn't look like a Fast and Furious movie to me. I know some of you like the Jungle Cruise trailers, and that's also coming out next year, by the way. We'll see if, with the delays, if Black Adam still makes its 2021 release date. The Rock maybe should look into why he's having some trouble getting people excited about the projects he's working on, because they should be. They look good to me. But anyway, Adam Smasher's lack of popularity gives the film and Centineo the chance to do something interesting without the pressure of pleasing fans. No one's going to go in being like, they better get Adam Smasher right. Right? However, there's always the chance of underwhelming fans by going generic or upsetting fans by doing something too crazy or too Hollywood or too all the boys I've loved before. We don't need anyone rolling their eyes or throwing up in their mouth a little bit when they watch this movie. To all the boys I've loved before, fans are going to show up no matter what if they get to look at Noah Centineo. DC fans are going to be more easily miffed. As I said, I need to see more of the cast before I can see really how this movie is shaping up. So who is Adam Smasher? What can he do? He's basically a super strong Ant-Man, so ooh, it's on! That's funny, Paul Rudd versus Noah Centineo. It just goes to show how interesting the casting was of Paul Rudd in that role. Noah Centineo, of course, is more of a Hollywood casting choice. He's also most famous in the comics for his romance with Stargirl. Now, Stargirl, as I reported, was going to be in Black Adam on the JSA as she is in the comics, but since she's now assembling JSA Jr. over on the CW and just got renewed for a second season, I've heard that Cyclone will be taking her place on the team. So expect a romance between Cyclone and Adam Smasher, or at least a flirtation, especially to, again, please those Centineo fans. I think the team will actually look even more like the Bad Boys for Life team, which had tiers in terms of age range, which itself, by the way, borrowed from Fast and Furious. And as I reported earlier, the lineup that we're looking at for JSA in the Black Adam movie will be Adam Smasher, now Cyclone, Hawkman and Hawkgirl, and Dr. Fate. I think Dr. Fate will wear his helmet, but even he will probably take it off for a decent amount of time. As I said when I covered Dr. Fate in the Injustice 2 trailer, no actor wants their face covered. I mean, James Marsden complained about it a whole lot. I don't think you can get around Dr. Fate wearing his helmet some of the time, but he's only going to, I bet, wear it for his action sequences or when he needs to use his powers. All right, so no word on if, again, the original Green Lantern or Flash will be on the team, which is understandable because those brands are busy elsewhere. But to comic book readers, they are such iconic members of the JSA, I would think they would at least maybe have some kind of cameo to really help to get fans excited. Or else fans are just going to harp on it. You know, you got to get out in front of this stuff, producers of these movies. Black Adam's own love interest, Isis, also needs to be cast, which means there's a lot of potential romance in this movie. We got not just one, but two, but three couples. Forget double dating, that's a triple date for Black Adam. And maybe you can be the fourth couple if you take your date to the film. Maybe I use that as an ad campaign. Will all these roles, all these casting roles, be announced before DC Fandom so they can appear on the panel together? I've heard casting announcements are imminent. I would think that Dwayne Johnson would want to keep some of them a secret until the big day. Let's see if he can do it. Also, I know most of you don't care about any of this casting. What you really want to know about is The Rock's ex-wife and business partner's most famous client. I don't believe she represents The Rock, but if whether or not he's going to show up, Mr. Henry Cavill. Now, he did trend all day yesterday, and he's not in any project. Nobody will hire the poor guy. He has The Witcher Season 2 coming up, of course. But he trended all day yesterday for posting an Instagram video of himself very suggestively building a computer from scratch, a gaming computer, which was a clever touch. The whole thing was brilliant. Cavill, either he came up with it or Danny Garcia did, or someone in that camp did, and it's an absolutely fantastic bit of self-promotion. I hope it really helps cement him getting the Black Adam cameo. I think that's where he's going to show up first because from what I hear, he's still not getting along with a lot of the top brass at Warner Brothers. So anyway, Are you excited to see Adam Smasher and or Noah Centineo? Or can you at least get over it? And if you're not a DC fan, but if you're a Noah Centineo fan, what's going to get you excited about this movie? Also, how do you think Black Adam's developing overall? Share your thoughts down below, subscribe today, and of course, as always, you can check out some more videos right now.